Next talker, Vladimir.
Okay.
Next talker, Vladimir Kozlov.
Sorry, it's not the first
question. Of Stokes waves with vorticity.
Wait a moment. It was the end. Okay, here is the beginning. Great. Yeah, great. Okay. Can you hear me?
Yes, okay.
Yeah, okay, good. So thank you for inviting me for this conference. I am very happy to participate in this conference. And my talk was announced, and it's about subharmonic bifurcations of Stokes waves with vorticity. It's a two-dimensional problem. It is described by the motion of fluid in the two-dimensional channel is described by Euler equation. It's two equations for the velocity vector u and uv. It's two components, one horizontal and another vertical. And the fluid is incompressible, so the divergence two-dimensional is equal to zero. And there are boundary conditions. The first one on the free surface, so which described by the function eta. And it means that we follow the surface, the fluid. And on the bottom, it's no slip boundary condition. And another boundary condition that the pressure is continuous on the boundary. So it's equal to the atmosphere pressure. So it's quite usual formulation in this setting. And we are looking for so-called steady water waves, which means that it has some special dependence on the t. It like x minus ct. So it means that if you are on the surface, so it is a steady. So you can think that it doesn't move, because it moves and keep the same shape all the time. Okay, so there are, one can think about two type of flows. Unidirectional flow, it's when one component, horizontal component, is non-zero. So we have a flow in one direction. And it is possible also to consider flows with a different direction. So the direction of fluid, of flow in the fluid, in the channel can be different in different parts of the channel. So, but we will consider only unidirectional flows in this talk. So the flow flows in one direction. So usually one can describe such problems by with the help of one function, so-called stream function. So since the flow is divergent free, so you can introduce the function psi and express both components of velocity as one as derivative respect to x and another as derivative respect to y. And then there is a certain invariant for this, not invariant, but the vorticity omega, which actually depends only in this case of psi. One can show that it is well known. So if we use this vorticity function, so the problem which I am going to talk about can be written as follows. So we have a two-dimensional domain, the bottom, which is flat, and is described by y is equal to zero. And inside you have a Laplace equation, but with nonlinear term, omega of psi. Omega is known function, so you can choose to describe different type of flows, but it is known. And since we are dealing with unidirectional flow, so derivative psi y can be considered as positive. So on the surface, we have two boundary conditions. The boundary is unknown. The function eta and the function psi must be found. So they are unknowns. Therefore, we have two boundary conditions on the free surface. One psi is equal to one. So it's flux is constant on surface and on the bottom. One can show. And another is so-called Bernoulli boundary condition, which came from the fact that the pressure on the surface is equal to the pressure outside. And it can be described in terms of the function psi as it is written, 1/2 psi x squared plus 1/2 psi y squared plus it is equal to r. R is a certain constant, which is called Bernoulli constant. And one can see that the height of the free surface can't be arbitrary. So it can't be more than R. One can see this from the Bernoulli equation. And when it is R, then the gradient of the function psi at this point on the surface is equal to zero. And such points are called stagnation points. So where the gradient, you have a certain degenerate. So the boundary condition degenerates. Okay, but some about this, what is I need to know that you will have in mind to explain subharmonic bifurcations. So up to in last century, most attention and the most study was made for study Stokes and solitary waves. Stokes waves is waves like sine function. So you have one crest on the period. And Nekrasov was the first who proved the existence of small amplitude Stokes waves in the 1920s. And then Lavrentiev and later Lavrentiev, okay, and Friedrich Hess, they prove existence of small solitary waves. Solitary waves, it's roughly speaking, Stokes wave with infinite period. So it's one, it has only one crest maximum and tends to a certain constant at plus minus infinity. Okay, and then large amplitude Stokes waves was studied by Krasovsky Kedi, and the large amplitude Stokes waves and solitary waves by Amick and Toland. And this was in irrotational case. Irrotational means that vorticity is equal to zero. So it's a potential flow. I need also mention the Stokes conjecture. This is a famous conjecture by Stokes. So when you approach, when you have a point, stagnation point on the surface, so you have an angle 120 degrees. And it was a very old conjecture and it was solved by Toland in 78. And so he proved that it can happen that you have stagnation points, but about the angle, they proved later in 79 and 81. And then Amick, Frenkel, and Plotnikov, they give independent proofs of these facts. General analysis of singularities, it was also some books about general analysis of singularities. So you have stagnation points and you can use a technique which one used to study problem with free boundaries and study the shape of surface around stagnation points. And it was done by Varvaruka Weiss, and they show that if you have stagnation point, and so they are isolated and the angle is 120 degrees in irrotational case when you have no vorticity. Now the wave with vorticity, they are more complicated. And the first work in this direction. So they are described by the same equation, but with vorticity. So if you have no vorticity, so it's zero. So you have only Laplacian, and you have only non-linearity due to free surface and the Bernoulli boundary condition. So large amplitude flows was constructed first by Konstantin and Strauss in 2004. And then Varvaruka, he studied the stagnation points, and then Wheeler did this for solitary waves. So it is very important also, I will use this because I will talk about bifurcations, that usual set to prove the existence of large amplitude Stokes waves is to construct branches of water waves. So they start from some trivial when the free surface is horizontal. So it's a uniform stream solution, so called. And then they can develop the shape somehow. And then in such a way, you can construct by continue this shape development, you can construct large amplitude water waves. And then you make, there are some general theorem which says that you can do this up to a certain limit, and one can describe this limit, and then one should study these possible alternatives for this limit, and one can extract in such a way large amplitude water waves, and in particular waves with stagnation points on the surface. And such technique was developed in it started from works of Toland and Arnik, but for vorticity case, they was developed by Konstantin and Strauss and Varvaruka. We did this also recently to show that there are such branches which can approach this stagnation point on the surface with angle 120 degrees. So properties around stagnation points, so you can consider separate stagnation points and describe the shape of the profile. And there is some lists of works which are important in this direction. So, up to 1980, almost all works in this area were developed to Stokes or solitary waves. And actually one can see the watch on the ocean surface that the waves, water waves, are more complicated. So it's not only Stokes and solitary waves, and it is some big question, can this theory based on earlier equation and this model, can this theory describe and produce more complicated water waves, which are more relevant to real world waves? And the first observation was made by Chen, Safman, and Safman is two different papers, so it's not the first paper, Chen Safman, and then Safman is separately. They numerically find that there exist different types of waves. And they started from, they consider a rotational case, and they started from a branch of waves, water waves. They start from horizontal wave, some trivial. And then it develops and reach at the end the Stokes wave, extreme waves. So the waves with stagnation points of the surface. And they discovered that for certain values of parameter, we parameterize such branches. It can happen that you have bifurcation and new type of waves bifurcates from certain points on this branch. And so they have a period, and there is some crest, and there is another small crest also. So it has it's different from Stokes waves. And there were more papers, numerical papers in this direction, but the only theoretical work was done in 2000 by Buffoni, Dancer, and Tolan. They proved theoretically the existence of such waves. So the wave is actually, you start from a branch of periodic waves of a certain period, but it appears that you can consider at the same time, because this period repeats to the left and to the right, and so you can take large period, and it appears that there are bifurcation on a larger period, and they produce new type waves, and such bifurcations, they are called sub harmonic bifurcations. And so it is good to mention the work of Plotnikov, because he started to use a certain technique by analyzing bifurcation from a branch of solitary waves. And he discovered conjecture, proof that this is not right. And the technique which he suggested was used by Buffoni, Dancer, and Tolland. So this is the only work, and therefore the purpose was to prove and to look at this phenomenon again, and to try to prove this for vorticity. Okay, so actually they prove only for the general with of infinite depths. So for finite depths, it was unknown. Now I can turn to the subject of my talk. So we consider steady water waves on free surface of rotational depth. So we have the same equation which I already presented. So you have a stream function psi, which satisfy non-linear equation, it's Laplacian plus some known functions of psi. And so you have two-dimensional channel, the free surface is described by y is equal to eta of x, and you have Bernoulli equation, and the function psi is equal one and zero, so it means that the flux is constant on free surface and on the bottom. So it's a known fact, and you can scale the all functions and variables to get this problem with the only parameter R. And basically also the another parameter which is which we have in this problem is the period. So we consider here Stokes waves. And we start our analysis with a certain branch of waves. We assume that we have a branch of solutions which parameterized by a certain parameter S. And such branches are constructed already. And it's not so simple, but it is known that there are such branches, and to express their property, because just now it's branches of psi, eta, and L. And you have different domains for different S and different periods for different S, so it is more convenient to have fixed domain and fixed period and to simplify formulation of our result. And this can be done by using so-called partial Hadamard transformation. So I write formally this partial Hadamard transformation. And after applying this transformation, you get the following nonlinear problem. So it's more nonlinear. So, but now we are looking only for one function, h. And omega is an integral of, large omega is an integral of a small omega, and it is only a function. So we have no nonlinear term small omega of psi. Instead, it came as, because derivative of large omega is small omega, but it depends only on p. So it's the usefulness of partial Hadamard transformation. But certainly we have a nonlinear still equation instead of Laplacian. And but the domain Q now is constant. So it's only from P from 0 to 1. And we are looking for the function H. And the function H is the variable Y. So you write Y. So therefore Y on the surface for P is equal to 1 give the shape of the free surface psi. So therefore, we now looking for a solution of this problem, and the branch can be formulated in terms of HP. Now we have the following branch. So we have the H, which depends on PQ as variables and parameter S. And both H and lambda, it's not lambda zero, but lambda, the even function periodic of fixed period lambda now zero, because we make normalization. And it is known that it can be constructed as branches which are analytically depends on S, with values in its C to alpha is two derivatives, and alpha is Herder class. And lambda is also analytic function in S. So another property of such branches which are known are that they, for S is equal to zero, it's uniform stream solution, so they do not depend on P. So it corresponds to free surface which is horizontal. And the function H depends only on P for S is equal to zero. And another fact, so you must approach the Stokes extreme wave. So there exists Sj, and when J tends to infinity, so H tends to R. So this is exactly give you an stagnation point, extreme wave, and which corresponds to the angle 120 degrees. This is very important. So we start from a certain branch, we start from horizontal surface, and then approach the Stokes extreme wave with stagnation point and with tangent angle 120 degrees. So this is the basic object. And in order to, so we have this branch, but we want to study bifurcation. So we must consider more general solutions, and we can pitch up a little bit H and take the difference, and we obtain the following functions in the left hand side. They are quite complicated. But the fact is that you can write the bifurcation equations, so equations for which describe bifurcations. And they can be written as f is equal to zero in Q and g is equal to zero on the surface. And it's equation with respect to W, and W is equal to zero on the bottom for P is equal to zero. It's more convenient possibly to write it as a Dirichlet-Neumann operator. So we introduce the Dirichlet boundary conditions, and one can show that for small s, this problem, the problem three is solvable. And for G, Dirichlet data, you can solve this equation with respect to W, and then calculate the boundary condition G on the surface P is equal to one. And you obtain only one equation on the surface with respect to G. And this is bifurcation equation. So now we are looking for bifurcations with respect to S. And one can write linear part of this equation. So all bifurcation, most of bifurcation results, they depends on analysis of Fréchet derivative and the spectral properties of Fréchet derivative. So it's quite simple to extract the spectral problem which corresponds to Fréchet derivative, and it is written here. It's on the boundary. So you have equation, elliptic linear, and on the boundary, it's like Stekhov boundary spectral, Stekhov spectral problem. Now we can, what is subharmonic bifurcation? So before we consider still functions G lambda zero periodic, but instead we can consider all operators introduced above as operators defined on functions with period M times lambda zero, where M is integer. And all operators, they can be applied due to the fact that the function psi, the branch which we started from, all functions are had the period lambda zero. So you can consider them also on functions of period m lambda zero. And then you have another branch of solutions with respect to S. And the question is to describe bifurcations of this branch on functions of period m lambda zero, and choose m possibly in the right way to get a new type of solutions. And to highlight that this all functions and operators depends on M, we can use the index M everywhere. For example, F and G, which we introduced as nonlinear operators, we can write as FM and GM as operator, which are defined on M times M, lambda zero periodic functions. And the same for S. Equations for subharmonic bifurcations can be written as SMGS is equal to zero, and SM now acts from the.
Excuse me. Two minutes remain.
What?
2 minutes. Excuse me.
Yeah. Okay. So I'm almost finished. And now let us denote by S tilde J singular points of operator S of S. So it's operators where the Fréchet derivative kernel of Fréchet derivative is zero. So this is exactly a good candidates for bifurcations, but for period lambda zero. The main theorem is the following. They exist as JMJ, infinitely many such pairs. And SJ, it's a bifurcation point for subharmonic equation, are different for SK tilde, it's bifurcation points for usual bifurcations. And both of them tends to infinity, such that SJ hat is bifurcation point for the equation SMJ GS. So now it's different from bifurcation points for usual bifurcations of period lambda zero. So we obtain a new type of bifurcations, which are completely different from Stokes' way. And the second assertion, so here was Sj tends to infinity and Mj tends to infinity. And we can also get similar result, but now only Mj tends to infinity, but Sj different pairwise, and they are bound. So it's main theorem, which shows that there are subharmonic bifurcations. Yes, thank you for your attention.
Questions, please. Maybe I missed, what is about three-dimensional system?
Three-dimensional system, they are, nothing is known about subharmonic bifurcations. And so there are many works on three-dimensional systems, so it depends on. So you make, you must put some questions because there are many works. One, you can consider periodic solutions in one direction, and in another direction you have also some periodicity but with different periods, or possibly you have a three-dimensional problem with waves which is periodic in one direction and solitary in another direction, or there are more complicated problems.
Okay, thank you.
But subharmonic bifurcation, such investigations, it's the first one after the old, which was 20 years old. So this is a new one.
Okay, more questions, please. Let us thank again.